The opening scene to the first episode of The Bad Batch shows Caleb Doom, or Kanan Jarrus, returning to his master, who is in battle against the Separatist forces. He tells her their reinforcements are right behind him. When the reinforcements arrive, Depa Balaba and her clones are shocked that Caleb had only brought 5 soldiers. But they were quickly learned who these 5 were. The soldiers of Clone Force 99, the experimental unit of clones with special enhancements. Shortly after the group dubbed the Bad Batch saved the day and in the battle, Order 66 is executed and Depa Balaba is gunned down in front of young Caleb Doom. Horrified, Caleb runs, but it seems Clone Force 99 is immune to Order 66, except one, Crosshair. But what if everything isn't what it seems with the sharpshooting clone? Today, on Star Wars Fanatic. And go on and subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already, and turn on notifications to stay alerted when I post new Star Wars content, and hit the like button to show your love for what I do here. Now, let's get right into it. The Bad Batch is made up of 5 members at the beginning of the series: Hunter, Wrecker, Echo, Tech, and Crosshair, each with a special ability. Today, we'll focus on Crosshair, with his unmatched ability to hit a target with deadly accuracy. When Order 66 is given, the Bad Batch hear about it through Tech, who is monitoring comms. Palpatine didn't send it directly to them, but when they see Depa Balaba murdered, Hunter tells Crosshair that they will find the kid to make sure nothing happens to him, while the others get to the bottom of it. So, the only way the Bad Batch hears of Order 66 is through Tech. When Hunter and Crosshair find Caleb hiding in a tree, Hunter tries to coax him down, but Crosshair takes a shot at the young Jedi. One thing leads to another, and Crosshair is knocked unconscious while Hunter continues the chase. Caleb eventually loses Hunter, but Hunter tells Crosshair the child fell to his death in a chasm. Crosshair is suspicious and tells Hunter he knows he let the boy escape. So it seems only one member of Clone Force 99 has fell victim to Order 66. Crosshair. From the time they return to Kamino, Crosshair has made it clear that he will kill them for treason. And since then, Crosshair has been working for the newly established Empire as a unit leader of conscripted stormtroopers, marking the beginning of Project Warmantle. At every turn, Crosshair has been on the trail of the rest of the Bad Batch, and now he has been injured by them with a shot of ion blast from a dismantled Republic cruiser on Braca, the planet used to scrap out old service warships. So, it seems Crosshair's inhibitor chip may begin to fail. If that happens, he could potentially rejoin his brothers of Clone Force 99 in their quest to escape the Empire. But for now, he is still following the directives given through Order 66 and the Empire. But what if the directive of Order 66 faded already? What if Crosshair is now acting on his own free will? There are some things that make me think this may be the case. The first thing is Cut Laquane. When the Bad Batch are seeking refuge, they run into a former clone who left the life of war to start a family with a Twi'lek wife and their 2 children. When they were talking to Cut, he told them about Order 66 and that Captain Rex had been there the day before. Cut Laquane doesn't seem to be affected by the directive. So? Well, the Emperor didn't know of his self-imposed exile and didn't send the direct order to him. This is true, but then again, Clone Force 99 never got the order from Palpatine either. Let's go back a little bit. When Clone Force 99 was told of Order 66 at the beginning of the directive, it wasn't through an official order. It was Tech that told them about it from monitoring the comms. If you look at Crosshair, as soon as Tech mentions the order, his demeanor doesn't change all that much. And when Hunter told him they were going to find Caleb Doom and make sure nothing happens to him, Crosshair doesn't argue. A little further back, when Captain Rex told Jesse and the other clones that Ahsoka was not a Jedi and should be spared, immediately Jesse told Rex he was a traitor and would be taken into custody. Crosshair should have done the same if the order was affecting his inhibitor chip. Now, let's go back to Cut Laquane. The exiled clone heard of Order 66 the same way Crosshair did, through word of mouth from another clone. Yet, he is unfazed by it. So it seems the order had to come from the Emperor himself. So, Why was Crosshair affected by it when he heard it secondhand from Tech? Maybe he wasn't. Now let's look at Crosshair as a sharpshooter. When we see him aiming at live targets or droids, he rarely misses a kill shot. He is deadly accurate, and that's why he has his name. Yet, when he aims at Caleb Doom for the first time, he aims at the branch supporting the young Padawan in the tree. Caleb doesn't have his lightsaber out yet, and Crosshair doesn't aim to kill him, even though he could have. He just exposes him. When Caleb falls and pulls out his lightsaber, Crosshair then gives a good show by aiming at the kid. Crosshair, like any other clone that has seen Jedi in battle, knows they can deflect shots easily, as long as there aren't too many aiming at the Jedi at the same time. In fact, Crosshair would also know that deflecting blaster bolts is one of the first things taught to younglings and Padawans. Need evidence of that? Well, okay, look in A New Hope. Obi-Wan is instructing Luke to deflect blaster shots, the first time Luke uses a lightsaber. In Attack of the Clones, when Obi-Wan interrupts Yoda training younglings, they are practicing deflecting blaster bolts in form techniques. But wouldn't Crosshair be afraid that Caleb would deflect a shot back at him? Maybe, but he would also be counting on Caleb being too inexperienced to have mastered deflecting shots back at his enemies. And he was right. So my thought is that Crosshair was actually helping the boy escape, putting him on the run, and making sure he didn't trust any clones from this moment on. And we see that he doesn't in Star Wars Rebels when Kanan Jarrus, formerly known as Caleb Doom, meets Rex, Wolf, and Gregor. He does not trust them at all. Okay, so why would Crosshair fake his directive of Order 66, then murder a village of refugees under Imperial order? Well, the simple answer is to infiltrate the Empire for the Bad Batch, to see what the Empire is up to. Omega saw it in Crosshair's eyes that he missed his brothers and there was hope for him. We also see Crosshair sit in the barracks of the former clone Force 99 and show signs of missing them. Yet Crosshair is playing a part and he is playing it well. He is convincing to the Empire, so much that he even ordered the murder of refugees on Onderon and convinced them to let him track down Clone Force 99. And that made it convincing to us as an audience. They had to do something extreme to get us on board, to make us believe Crosshair is now bad and has turned into a mindless clone. But we will see a different Crosshair soon. He will rejoin his brothers or die trying. He may even be killed as a traitor. There's one thing that puts a wrench in this whole theory, but it's minor and it's something he could have heard over the comms and repeated, for us to think the chip was working, when he said, "Good soldiers follow orders." Another theory of mine is that maybe Order 66 never affected Crosshair and he is just acting on his own free will, not as a spy for the Bad Batch, but as an actual agent for the Empire. And when his inhibitor chip fails, he will continue to hunt his brothers. But that's for another video. Let's look at one more thing. Captain Howzer, the clone captain of Ryloth and friend of Champ Syndulla. During Order 66, the clones were basically lobotomized. They weren't even friendly with each other anymore. Case in point, how they acted to the Bad Batch. So their allegiance was to the newly established Empire, and that's where their loyalties lie. So why does Captain Howzer defend Champ Syndulla and cover for his daughter Hera? And also help them out at the end of the last episode? Because maybe Order 66 only lasts for a short time? Long enough for Project Warmantle to bring in conscripts and volunteers as stormtroopers, then discard, retire, or make the clones extinct. These are all just theories of mine. I don't necessarily think they will all be true or even confirmed. But what do you think? Do you have a theory on this, or is everything the way it seems? Let me know in the comments below. I'd love to hear from you. And if you are new here, go ahead and hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications to stay alerted whenever I post new Star Wars content. Also, hit the thumbs up to show your love for the hard work I put into each video. Let's blow this channel up one click at a time. Thank you for watching, and remember, this is the way, the only way.